Welcome to a tutorial on how you can convert any value to string in JavaScript. We are going to understand the nature of JavaScript strings along with the toString method to convert different value types into strings. Later, at the end of the video, we will have an in-depth look at string casting in JavaScript and how you can avoid fatal errors that might occur using the toString function. So let's get started. If you want the access to the source code to this video or need to follow along, you can easily do so by using the link to code Sandbox given in the description below. If you're watching this on Instagram, you can access description by double tapping on the title of the video. I also have a link to my Discord server and you can post your questions there and I would be certainly able to answer them for you. Okay. Now, strings in JavaScript are primitive types and are immutable. By being immutable, what I mean is that once a string is created, its value cannot be changed. Let's try to understand this with an example. Let me start by declaring a variable over here. Let language is equal to Java. Now I'm going to assign another string value to this variable. Language is equal to language plus script. Here I am just concatenating the previous value of the language variable, which is Java, with another string script so that the variable value now reads as JavaScript. Let's print the value of the language variable to the console and see what we get. So as expected, this is printing the complete word JavaScript to the console. But even though you used concatenation to append the string script to the initial value Java, JavaScript in the background created a new string called JavaScript. JavaScript here first created the new string and then deleted the previous string. The deletion of the string is the last process that is performed by JavaScript. This is because the strings in JavaScript are immutable. Looking at this example, it might look like a simple process of just adding a new piece of the previous value, but that is not the case. It's really important to understand this concept of immutability because whether a value type is mutable or not holds a lot of importance when you're working with complex applications, especially in React. Let's look at another tricky part related to strings. This happens when you're trying to convert another value into string. Let me declare a variable over here and call it a number and set the value of the variable to 15. I will convert this number to a string and log the number to the console. Number is equal to number.toString. Console.log type of number. There we see it in our console, our number has been converted to a string. Now this is a normal practice in JavaScript and you will use toString method quite often to convert values to strings. But there's a problem here. Let us suppose that the value of this variable is of the type null or undefined. This might happen in case of a function not returning a value or a null value in an object property being returned by an API or any other reason. Let's see what happens when variable is undefined. I will declare a new variable and not assign it any value. Now let's log the value to the console and see what we get. Console.log variable. Our variable returns undefined and that's what we expected. Now let's try to call the toString method to this variable and see what happens. Console.log variable.toString. See, we get an error. You see, toString will always throw an error if the value you are trying to convert to string is either null or undefined. Now, this might throw an error in production, especially if you have not tested your code for this edge case. Now, there would be a lot of solutions while you are writing production-ready code. which would include including this in a conditional statement or using strict type checking with TypeScript. Since we are talking about strings, let's look at a simple solution which, if implemented, will at least not throw error in production. The solution here is to use the string casting function rather than using the commonly used toString function. So let's see how it works. I will declare a few more variables of different value types. You can use string casting with the string method with a capital S, like so. Console.log string and pass the variable. I will go ahead and convert the rest of the variables to strings as well to see what value is returned by each one of them. Let's see our console to check what we got. Now you will notice that string function does not throw an error if the value is undefined or null. Instead, it would convert them to the literal text of each of those values. This, as I said, is not the ideal solution, but at least would not throw fatal errors in production if any of those values that you're trying to convert to string turns out to be null or undefined. I'm coming up with more such videos and a complete series on tricky parts of JavaScript and lots of advanced concepts as well. If there are some specific questions related to this video, you can post them in the comments below and I will answer them for you. Please consider subscribing to my channel so that you're able to watch the most recent videos, and that helps me a lot with the YouTube algorithm as well. I will see you in the next video. Till then, you take care. Cheers.